Good morning, everyone. First, I would like to thank Rich and the entire FUJIFILM team to invite me here, and it's really good to see everyone. Yeah, we've been missing this conference for the last couple of years, so it's good to be back in person. Okay, yeah, it was good to see all the presentation yesterday, and you know, it was good to learn about different products and different services which different companies are doing. And just today, I'd like to offer the perspective from a hyperscaler, how Microsoft Azure is looking at the data growth. And also, I would offer some feedback for the tape industry. Switching gear a little bit, talking specifically about tape. As we all know, the tape has been around for a long time. I think 1950s, when it's, in one presentation yesterday, I was talking about when it first started at IBM. So there's a long history, and it's a mature and established ecosystem. You know, the products and the technology is being developed for enterprise for a long time as well. So from a Microsoft perspective, we have a long association with the tape industry as well. So yeah, so Microsoft has a long association, and I'd like to thank for that partnership to the tape industry. And another thing is, you know, tape is still the most cost-effective storage medium. So now I'll offer some candid feedback here that we have observed, because we have been working with not just tape, but all other storage medium devices as well. And what we have seen over a period of time is, you know, the other storage products like HDD and SSD, so they have made the pivot. You know, as you know, they've largely, because that's where all these opportunities came from, they were focused on the enterprise only. But, and as we have talked about, the cloud use cases are different because we have a large focus on scalability, performance. So these guys have made that pivot, and they are now developing products which are specifically for the cloud use cases. So things like dual actuator HDDs, QLC NAND, SMR, ZNS. So these kind of technologies are being developed by keeping the cloud requirements in mind. And what these guys have also done is, you know, for example, SMR and ZNS, these technology offer the additional density of the devices, which otherwise the native wouldn't have been possible. And these have led to the TCO improvement. And also, as a result of that, you know, the larger mind share and also the share of wallet for these products. So my ask to the tape industry would be to, you know, to follow the suit, you know, have the products and technologies that are specifically designed for cloud. So one thing I would say is the predictability and execution of the product roadmap. I was talking to a few people yesterday and then this morning as well, what this is, statement actually mean. From a cloud perspective, if you think, cloud needs to execute on a predictable product roadmap so that they can offer the capacities as well as the cost improvement which the customer desire. And if there is no, if the roadmap behind that is not predictable, then it becomes very hard. So so that's one thing is needed. Then second is the product themselves. You know, one of the main challenges, and I think this is probably known, and then we have talked about it in the past as well, is Microsoft specifically, I don't know about others, but Microsoft specifically have a lot of data centers which are adiabatically cooled. And those adiabatic data centers, as you can imagine, are not conducive for tape. So it becomes challenging. So, you know, this is one thing tape industry needs to take a look and see what can be done to address this this challenge. And it can potentially unlock the key. It can potentially unlock the opportunities that the tape needs to participate in the zettabyte opportunities that the cloud might bring.